I opened this CT of this patient that we have the periapical x-ray here to correlate the 2D to the 3D. Before that, let's go ahead and see the landmarks that we have on a CT scan. CT, as you know, it's computerized axial tomography. In dentistry, what the machines we have are not CT, actually. We call it CT, but they are cone beam. There's a difference in the technology that is used. Cone beam uses a technology which radiates the patient much, much less, but also it does not have as much data as a regular medical CT scan. So it's accurate to call it cone beam, but cone beam, try to explain that to the patient. Did you bring your cone beam? Or, you know, they don't understand, but everyone knows CAT scan. So we call it CAT scan. It's more or less shows the same thing, but here, for the purpose of education, know that in dentistry, these machines, these are cone beam machines, which are different in terms of the way they section, the way they expose the patient. The exposure is less, and the data is less too. So, the idea is to get three-dimensional radiograph of the patient. Means the periapical lesion shows only from the buccal to the lingual where the sensor is. It's two-dimensional. We see x-axis, y-axis. We do not see how deep this bone is. And it's important for us to know how deep this bone is, because here I see it a little bit darker, so I say this is thin, and the doctor is saying here, yeah, if it's thin, then you have to go 1 millimeter above it to get to thick bone, and it's all valid point, but we're all assuming these things. We don't know if it's thick or thin, or how thick or how thin it is. Sometimes this may be a little blade of bone that none of it is usable. Sometimes right from the outset, it could be like an inch thick, and you can put two implants side by side. So this does not give us all the information we need to have in order to plan for our implants. This, however, the 3D does it, because it can section this area and then show us from the side on the Z axis how that bone is. So the first thing a CT scan can do is to give us from three different dimensions. See, this is from looking down up, and it's somewhat in the middle of the maxilla. This is looking from the forward back, and this is looking from the side. Okay, so these are the main views. This is the capability of the CT scan, that it can show you from different sections. See, this is a section from bottom up, forward, backward, and the side.